वेलकम एवरीबडी. वी हैव कंप्लीटेड टॉपिक ऑन बेरिंग्स एंड क्रचेस. नाउ लेट अस सॉल्व सम असाइनमेंट्स, सम प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन दिस टॉपिक. सो वी हैव सम प्रॉब्लम्स विथ अस. लेट अस डिस्कस देम हाउ दे आर सॉल्व. सो द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम इज ए सबमरीन एक्सर्ट्स अ थ्रस्ट ऑफ 120 किलो न्यूटन्स ऑन इट्स प्रोपेलर शाफ्ट. It has six collars with internal diameter 250 mm and outer diameter, that is external diameter, 550 mm. The engine rotates at 100 rpm and the coefficient of friction is given as 0.1. Determine the power that is absorbed in friction assuming the two conditions, uniform pressure condition and uniform wear condition. Now this problem is fairly simple. If you see whatever is given, then you'll notice that axial load is given W, capital W, as 120 kilonewtons, which is the thrust. Thrust is nothing but axial load. Then there is coefficient of friction given. The speed is given somewhere as 100 rpm. Now 100 rpm we are going to convert into radians per second, angular velocity. So 2 pi n by 60, that gives us some this figure, radians per second. Now there are six such collars which are used for the purpose of transmission. So n becomes 6, and then the collar which is there, which is having some frictional plates, so that has got outer and inner diameter as 550 and 250. So we have to take radius, means we have to make half of this. Now the two conditions, constant pressure condition, let us see how do we work out the power that is absorbed for constant pressure condition. Now one thing you have to keep in mind, although it is not written here, for all these problems, whatever derivations we are using, whatever formula you are using, those formula you have to derive and then solve the problem. So right now in this case, what case we are talking about, this is a case of a collar friction which has got outside and inside diameter and uniform pressure. So last time we have seen the tabular form. So that table, if you refer, then you have to select a suitable formula and that is to be designed. So right now I am not showing the design, the derivation part, only the final answer. So the torque in this case comes as 2/3 of mu w r1 cube minus r2 cube upon r1 square minus r2 square. This is in newton meters. You have to write the units every time, which is most important. Now in this example, if you see, we are given everything. Mu is there, W is there, R1, R2 is also there. D1, D2 is there. You can convert that into R1, R2. And then you can directly get this answer of the torque that is available at the propeller shaft, which comes in Newton meters. But then remember, I am repeating, this needs to be derived. To be derived, I'll write here, to be derived. To be derived. Then the next is, we are asked power. So as you know, power P in watts is given by torque in Newton meters into angular velocity in radians per second. Now we have got all these things. Torque we have got in Newton per meter, which you just now found out. And angular velocity also we know here. So both these values are there. So you can find out the power that is transmitted in watts by using this formula, which you have to derive. Now the next is uniform wear condition. Again, for uniform wear condition, torque has got certain derivation and the outcome of the derivation is mu w, half mu w r1 plus r2 in Newton meters. Again, everything is there, so you can get the answer. You have to, of course, convert that into proper units. See, here it is in Newton meters. The data given is in millimeters. Moreover, it is diameter. So you have to convert this into radius and convert this into meters and then use it here, because the formula says it requires in Newton's meter. Newton's meter. So we will get this value after proper conversion. Remember, I am repeating, you have to derive this formula, come to this place, this level, and then use this formula and go ahead and solve this. Then the next thing, of course, is simple. P is equal to T into omega. Now everything is there. You can solve this. So the power in watts is this much. So for this example, it's a very simple example, uniform pressure, uniform wear. You should be able to derive this equation, and then once you know torque, everything else is given, you can easily find out torque. Then you can find out T into omega to get power in watts. Same thing, only the formula for torque is different for uniform wear and the formula of torque different for uniform pressure. So this is problem number one. Now let's see problem number two. Okay, now the statement of the problem is here. A tractor shaft has multiple collars with external diameter 500 mm and internal diameter 300 mm. A uniform pressure is exerted on the collars with intensity 0.4 newton per mm square. The coefficient of friction is given as 0.06, and you are asked to find out the amount of power absorbed when the shaft rotates at 100 rpm while taking axial load of 200 kilonewtons. We are also asked to find out the total number of collars required. Now this problem, if you write down whatever is given, then you will find intensity of pressure is given 0.4 newton per mm square, coefficient of friction is given, shaft speed it is rotating at some 100 rpm, which you have to convert into radians per second. Then there is a axial load also given somewhere, this one, 200 kilonewtons. And collar dimensions are also there, 500 and 300, D1, D2. They are diameters, not radius. We require radius. So this data is given and we are asked to find out the power. So in fact, this part is just like last time. The only thing is now, this problem, since we are solving this as assignment problems, the derivation of torque, if you have done it earlier, in the earlier problem, you need not do it again here. But in the exam, remember, these problems, when they are asked in the exam, you have to derive and after that you have to use it. Right now, for this, you need not derive because it is already derived earlier and we are solving this as set of assignments, as one set of all the problems forming one assignment. So you need not derive it here in the second problem because it is the same formula, that's why. So you get this answer in Newton meters and in power, T into W, since not W, in between omega. So T into omega, you can find out watts, since both are known. T is just now found out and omega is already worked out earlier. So that my amount of power will be lost. Now here they are asking number of collars required, that is how many collars, n number of collars. Now we know intensity of pressure. Small p, and that is given as 0.4 newton per mm square. Now what is intensity of pressure? That is load upon area. So we have got load W, and area of one plate is pi R1 square minus R2 square, and like that there are n number of collars. So area of each collar is this, like that there are n collars. So this is the total area which is bearing the load, which is taking the load W, which is the axial load, which is given as 200 kilonewtons. Remember, this you have to make it in newtons. This kilonewton you are not going to use, you are going to make it newtons, because the formula for pressure is newtons per mm square. So here value of pressure is there, load is given, radius also we know, so you can easily find out how many collars we require. So those many number of collars you will require, which is for second problem. Let's take the next problem. Now this is the third problem. Now this problem is on conical pivot. A vertical shaft of 200 mm diameter is supported in a conical pivot bearing with cone angle as 120 degrees. It carries an axial load of 40 kilonewtons and the coefficient of friction is 0.025. The shaft rotates at 150 rpm. You are asked to find out the power loss in friction for uniform pressure and uniform wear condition. Now this time it is a conical pivot. You can see that the axial load is given 40 kilonewtons, which is 40 into 10 raised to 3 newtons. Cone angle is given 120 degrees, which is double of what we are requiring in the formula. If you remember the figure, then alpha is half of the cone angle. So it is 2 alpha is 120 degrees. Accordingly, alpha will come as 60 degrees. Then the shaft diameter is given as 250 mm, that is radius is 125. Coefficient of friction also is given. Speed is 150 rpm here, which is converted into radians per second like this. So the first thing is power loss for uniform pressure condition. Now here you have to derive the equation and come to this part that torque comes as 2/3 mu w r upon sin alpha. Now r is the radius, effective radius. Now in this example everything we have, so that you can get this directly, the answer in Newton meters, that is the torque that is available at the bearing. And then the power is T into omega, which is in radians per second. So this also answer you can get in watts. Remember, you have to derive this. I am just writing it here. To be derived, because we are doing this for the first time here. Then there is a constant wear condition, again how much power is lost. So this again you will have to derive. The answer comes as half of mu w r upon sine of half angle alpha. Again to be derived. To be derived. And then power is T into omega, which will get in watts. Fairly simple example it is. We have to find out, we have to derive the expression for torque, and then T into omega gives us power. In fact, all the three problems which we have solved, in most of the cases, power was asked. So procedure is almost everywhere same so far. Now when we go to the next problem, there is slight difference. Problem number 4 now. A powerboat engine is required to transmit 30 kilowatts at 2500 rpm using a single plate clutch with both sides effective. That means number of sides to n equal to 2. The ratio of outer to inner radius is 1.2. See here the radius value is not given, their ratio is given 1.2. Then the coefficient of friction is 0.3 given. The maximum permissible pressure, that is intensity of pressure, is 0.15 newton per mm square. Calculate the outer and inner radii of the frictional clutch plate and also find the axial thrust provided by the springs under uniform pressure condition. Under uniform pressure condition. Now see, in the earlier example during the lectures we have seen, in case of clutch which condition is used, in case of bearing which condition is used, that is if nothing is given. But if specifically something is mentioned like this, then you have to go as per this. Now this is a clutch plate. As per earlier conclusion, for clutches we are going by uniform wear condition, but they are mentioning to use uniform pressure condition, so we have to use pressure condition if it is mentioned like this. So we start like this. Power given as 30 kilowatts, that means 30 into 10 raised to 3 watts. Speed is given as 2500 rpm, which we convert into radians per second, 2 pi n by 60. Then coefficient of friction given 0.3. Ratio of R1 upon R2, radius ratio, 1.2 is given here. Then the intensity of pressure small p is given as 0.15 Newton per mm square. And number of active surfaces is 2, because it is written somewhere here, both the surfaces are effective. That means the number of sides are 2, n becomes 2. Now we go to find out the dimensions of the clutch plate. Calculate the outer and inner radius of the frictional clutch plate. So to find out the clutch plate dimensions. Now here R1 upon R2 is given as 1.2. Therefore R1 is equal to 1.2 times R2. Now power, I'm just showing you steps, you can find out. Power is T into omega. Now in this expression, power is given and omega also is given. So you can find out how much is the torque in Newton meters that is existing at the shaft. So we got the torque. Next thing is, since I think this problem, it is required, it should be pressure, it is uniform wear, it should be, it is given uniform wear. So now we say that P into R is C. So here we say P max multiplied by R minimum is equal to C. See, when P is higher side, R is on the lower side. So P max into R min, or P minimum R max. So that comes at C. Now in our case, P max I think is given, pressure is given, and R minimum is R2. So you can say 0.15 into R2. 0.15 is this, R2 is this. So we know the value of C in terms of R2. Next thing is, we find out the load, and that load is 2 pi C R1 minus R2. Now again, let me repeat, these equations you have to derive. How this has come, you have to show. So derivation here. So once you derive and come up to this, then you can say it is 2 into pi into C. Now C is this, 0.15 R2 into R1 minus R2. So this will come in terms of R2, because all our numbers, R1 you can convert into R2. So you will get load in terms of R2. Then there is a mean radius. That is R1 plus R2 upon 2. So this also you can find out in terms of R2. So we are having everything in terms of R2. Radius, this I can call this as R, capital R. In terms of R2, W in terms of R2, C in terms of R2. So now we will come to this formula. Torque is equal to number of plates mu, W and R. Now here torque is already known. Somewhere here we have found out the torque, numerical value. Then there is N known, mu is there, W in terms of R2 is known, and R is also in terms of R2. So this is containing R2, this is containing R2, all others are numbers. So you can find R2 equal to how much, and therefore R1 equal to how much. So we have found out the clutch dimensions. Next we are asking axial thrust. Now axial thrust is simple, it is already there somewhere here. Axial thrust is given by 2 pi C R1 minus R2, and we have now got the value of R2. So C was in terms of R2. So you can get, in fact, everything you can easily write and get the answer. So this is in Newtons, because everything now is available, R2, R1 in terms of R2, C in terms of R2, because R2 is found out just now. So axial thrust you can find out. This was the case of constant wear. So we have gone this P into R constant. So that was the fourth problem. Now let's go to the fifth problem. Now in this fifth problem, let me read the problem first. The engine of a mini truck rotates at 1800 rpm and transmits a power of 30 kilowatts. It is fitted with a multiple plate clutch having 3 discs on the driving shaft and 2 discs on the driven shaft. The clutch plates have outer diameter 260 mm and the inner diameter as 120 mm. Find the intensity of pressure under uniform wear condition if mu is 0.3. So let us see how this is worked out. We have been given power 30 kilowatts, that means 30,000, 30 into 10 raised to 3 watts. Then the number of collars are given for driving shaft and driven shaft. So N1 is 3 and N2 is 2. The clutch plate dimensions 260 mm and 120 mm. You have to make use of radius, not diameter, so half it. Make it half of this. Mu is 0.3. Then the speed is 1800 rpm. Convert that into radians per second. So having done this, we start with the power, and power is T into omega, and since we have power and omega given, this power is omega, so you can find out torque in Newton meters. So first thing is we found out the torque in Newton meters. Now let us find out the value of N. Now we know that value of N is N1 plus N2 minus 1. So in this case 3 plus 2 minus 1 will give us N as 4. Now the effective radius for this case, if you see the table, that comes as R1 plus R2 upon 2, and this is also known because R1 and R2 is given. Is it given? Yes, it is given. I have not written here. It is written D1, D1, D2. So this is known. Now the value of torque is given as